In this video, I'm going to show you how you can permanently add subtitles to your videos using SubtitleNext. Hi, my name is David from freelancerinsights.com, where we believe you should never stop learning. In the previous video, and I will link it up in the card above, I showed you how to add subtitles to your videos using Handbrake, a free tool that you can use to permanently add, ban, or hard code, whatever language you want to use, subtitles to your videos or movies. In this video, I want to use a professional captioning and subtitling software called SubtitleNext. And you can find SubtitleNext from subtitlenext.com. And it is a tool that I'd recommend for any freelancer starting out, or even if you have a full-blown professional TV station and all that. It's one of the best applications that you can use. So if you're a freelancer, your enterprise, a platform, or just offering subtitling and captioning services, you can consider trying out SubtitleNext. Now, this video is not sponsored. I have SubtitleNext open. So basically, as we did in the previous video, the Handbrake video, you need your video file, and you need the subtitle file, and you need the software. We're using SubtitleNext. So basically what we need to do for this video is that we need to import the video and import the subtitle file. So I'll go to video, open video file, and I want to browse to the folder that has my video file. It's the same folder, so I'll just click on it and click on open. On clicking on opening, I'll say okay. And I'll be set up to a couple of options where I'll get where do I want the media to start. The frame rate, use video frame rate, the video frame rate is this, whatnot, and all these things. So I'll just click on OK. Once I click on OK, if you look at my bottom right, is that it says processing media and shows the percentage. So basically, it's the media being ingested into SubtitleNext. And it also shows that the scene changes have actually been loaded. And the tip ID is now how to fix wrong subtitle numbering and all that. Unfortunately, it doesn't show the full name here on my screen. So basically, what I need to do now for us to see what is hidden here is just go to File, Open, and I need to open the subtitle file. I'm inside the folder with the video in the subtitle file, and all I need to do is come to this section. This section indicates SubtitleNext file, which are in an extension of .subn or .sub, and just click on the drop-down and go to the SRT section. And there are all other supported files shown here, but I just need the SRT. Now click on that, and the SRT file or the subrip file will show how to fix wrong subtitle numbering and timing using subtitle edit.srt. And I'll just click on it and click on open. And once I click on open, I'll be prompted to select the encoding. In the previous video, I showed you our video or the subtitle file was in UTF-8. So basically, I just need to search for one that has the encoding of like UTF-8. And it is this 65001 UTF-8. And click on it. And since this is not a right-to-left language that is like Arabic and all that, I won't do the reordering, just select that and click on OK. Once I click on OK, I'll select the timecode format. Since our video is in 30 frames per second, I'll just input that, 30, and click on OK. Once I click on OK, everything will preload. Now, once everything is preloaded, you can just ignore this section, since you're not working on a movie that needs to be translated and all that. But you can just leave the screen aspect ratio to be 16:9 and just click on OK. Just click on OK. And here's what happens. Here's where the magic happens. And you can see your video in this section. The subtitle will come up as you play. There are things that you can see here. These are called scene changes. There's some scene changes here, and use subtitles are also to your right of this. So you can just click on this, and it just jumps to that section. Now, basically, what we have here is almost identical to what we had in Handbrake, And basically, there is no styling per se other than the bolding and maybe the text color. So if I want to do a black background and change the font to be more white and remove the bold, I'll just come to Format, then go to Style. Once I come here, you see how it looks like. I need to go to the first section. I need the box type. There is none at the time. And I'll just click on Sized. I need it sized like that. And the box color should be black. You can select any type of color that you want. But I just prefer black. You can either do the fixed, that goes end to end, sized block, or the fixed block. But I prefer the sized. It looks more professional and adheres to how your caption text is. Then I also need to modify. Click on that modify and remove the bold from the text. You can see the changes come up here. And then change the color from that like grayish to white and click OK. This is whiter. And then I need to remove the edge, the shadow, set the values to 0 and the blur to 0. So I just click on OK. Now you can see the sample text, how it looks like. I'm satisfied with that, and I'll just click on OK. Now, see the change. That's it for now. I can actually just export this video to permanently add the subtitles to this video. But there's something that you need to notice, that when you do open captioning, the captions should not block information. For example, for this frame here, this text, edit, the INT seem to be blocked out. So with Subtitle Next, you can easily move this particular subtitle to this side. Now, once you move it to that side, you can clearly see the details that are going on here. So we can see and appreciate that. Since I already know where the scene changes in these files, so just click on that. I'll just move all the files before the scene change. Just move them to that section. Come to the next one here. It's also covering that. Just move it. There's also this one. It's also covering that. Sorry about that. Just come, hold it here, move it to the side. And since I know for this section, this scene change, that I already have now the scene changes here, and since I know that this file will not obscure anything that is relevant for this section, I can go ahead and burn in this. So I just wanted to show you this this easy way that you can easily appreciate the fact that with Subtitle Next, you can do the placement. You can either move it to the side, just move it up. If the text is just running down here. So basically, that's something that you can do with Subtitle Next. Now, basically, let's go to File and then click on Export. Now, once you click on Export, we want to export this file as an MP4. So just come here and select from the options that you can save as. And I need to save as a movie file. Just click on that. And I want to save it as a .mp4. Let's say burned subtitles .mp4 and click on save. Once I hit on save, I'll be prompted to select the source file. This is, as you can see here, source file, and the source file is this. So I just click on it and click on open. Once I select open, you'll get this movie burn window. It shows you the preview, the aspect ratio, the source, the output. So I'll just need to click on that. It says 16:9. I can either open the movie when finished or not, then custom bitrate. Let's go maybe with a 5000 kbps, and then I click on start. And depending on the strength of your machine, you can easily know how fast it's going to be. So it's saying about 6 minutes, 5 minutes. And when you look at what is going on, the subtitle files are being previewed, how they're going to look like once they're burnt into the video. So basically, you can see the preview as it's burning. So it's remaining about 4 minutes. And basically, This is how you actually burn subtitle files into a video using SubtitleNext. I wouldn't recommend SubtitleNext any less. I love the application. I love what it can do. And just the fact that I can change the format, the style, the text placement, vertical, horizontal, you know, to me, that is something that I'd really recommend. Change backgrounds to whatever color that you want. If you have a particular theme going on for your videos, you can easily change using this powerful application. Now, we'll wait for it to finish and see once it's finished how the videos preview like and how they look like. Depending on the option I selected for what I need the video to do once it's completed burning into the video, that is the subtitles, you'll either get the video just come back to your interface, the captioning interface, or just open the video if you selected the video to be opened. I'll just navigate to the folder where I have the video files, and the title we have is this one. So I'll just double click on it, and it's going to play in VLC. So just double click on it. And once I double click on it, today. Now, I'll just pause it there. You see how good this looks compared to the handbrake version? So let's just play it. I'm going to show you how you can fix wrong subtitle numbering and timing using Subtitle Edit. Hi, my name is David from freelancerinsights.com. Now, if you ask me, the version prepared using SubtitleNext looks way, way better than the version that we created using handbrake. But if you don't have this application, sometimes because it's a little bit pricey, but they have flexible pricing options, you can just use handbrake and have the subtitles burnt into your video or for your client easily and freely without any cost. If you're interested in learning how to caption and subtitle video, including learning how to add captions to videos permanently, which is referred to as open captioning, you can check out my captioning course from the link below to learn more. I hope that you learned something in this video and a new way to add captions to videos permanently. Kindly feel free to subscribe, like the video, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.